materials, I understand. Is that right?
Yeah.
So your science topic is materials. So I'm going to write down a word and I'm going to ask you to tell me what the word is. You can all tell me what the word is. So in this word, we've got two syllables. In the first clap, we had a vowel sound. Can you hear the vowel sound? What's the vowel sound? So a syllable needs to have a vowel sound in it. What sort of vowel can you hear in the first syllable? Is it a short sound or is it a long kind of a sound? What do you think? Yeah, it's an up, a short vowel sound, up. And then what comes after that short vowel sound? What can you hear? Up. What can you hear? So we first we hear up, and then we hear. Yeah. And in the word rubber, what two letters can you see that represent the b phoneme?
B.
There's two B's. So we have a short vowel, and then I can hear one consonant sound, but we write it with two letters. I have a long vowel here, then I have one consonant, okay? A consonant I can hear, that's the phoneme. One long vowel, one consonant. Do I double anything in that word?
No.
So there's just one P. One P there, but we've got two B's over here. Now, I have a question. My question is, how do I know when to double the consonant in the middle of a two-syllable word? How do I know when to double it, and how do I know when to not double it? That's my question. And you're going to find out for me, and this is your task. Each of you will get a list of words, and every word has two syllables. Okay, I'm going to give you a pile of scrap pieces of paper, little cards, and you're going to copy each of those words you see onto one of these, okay? So if I see the first word here is little, I'm going to write the word little here, and I'm going to get another piece of paper, cross the word little off, and then I'll go to the next word, which says throttle. I'm going to copy that word on another piece of paper and so on. And I want you to try and write as many of these words as you can down until I say stop, okay? So that's your first task. When you've got all your words written down on these pieces of paper, you can shuffle them around. And I'd like you, together with your partner, sort the words into two columns. Doubling and not doubling. If I had the word rubber, would that be in the doubling column or the not doubling column?
Doubling.
Yes. And what about paper?
Not doubling.
Okay. So that's what you're going to do. And then when you've sorted your words into those two columns, your job is to look very carefully at all of those words in those columns, each column, and work out a rule to teach me, or let's call it a generalisation, to teach me how do I know when to double and when not to double. And here's a clue. My clue is you need to look at what kinds of vowels and consonants you hear in the words when you say them. And what might help you too is as you write the words on the cards, so if it has a double letter, I might trace over it with a different colour pencil. And so I just can check what it has. And if it doesn't have any doubling, I'll just leave it alone. As you sort your words, you can write them down here as well. So consonant is doubled. We call that a consonant doublet. Can you say consonant doublet?
Consonant doublet.
And no consonant doublet.
And no consonant.
So which one is the consonant doublet word?
Rubber.
And which one is the no consonant doublet word?
Paper.
Okay, so you're going to write those words down here as well.